Hey YouTube, it's me, Elliot, also known as Elliot is a Cool Guy on most social media platforms. Lovely to meet you. This is my first video. I wanted to do YouTube for like a year now and I never got around to doing it. And then I started doing some videos for my Patreon and now I'm kind of have the motivation and the inspiration to put them on a global scale. So here we are. Elliot is now on YouTube. Thank you to everyone who has already subscribed before I started the channel. That's pretty sick. And I'm looking forward to more videos and future. Looking forward to the future of this channel. But yeah, this is my first video, so I thought I would do something cool. If you don't know me, I make funny kind of graphic design related content on my Instagram, and then I also live stream those designs on Twitch. I'll link in bio for all the following. And yeah, I just do like a whole bunch of cool stuff. I try to do some cool stuff. So today's video, I'm going to be doing a tutorial, one of my most requested kind of designs that people would like to know how to do, which is just a nice gradient orb, which has been seen. A lot of people have seen a lot of this on Instagram. This is going to be a Photoshop tutorial. So I'm sure it can be done on Illustrator and other programs like Affinity and stuff. I only know how to use Photoshop. So we're going to be going with Photoshop. We'll see how it goes. It's my first tutorial, so I'm sorry if it's a little bit rough, but hopefully it's nice and easy to follow. So let's bloody get into this thing. And just before we do that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And all the other things that YouTubers say you should do. All right, and leave a comment saying hi. All right, let's do it now. Here we are in Photoshop with a nice big 3000 by 3000 pixel file, just to give you an idea. When I do like noise and adding noise, the percentages and all that, you can adjust to whatever file size you are. The first thing I do is I'll just make a new layer on top of like a nice blank canvas. And we're just going to get some nice big like soft brushes, right? Nice big soft brushes in some colors of your choice. So I think for this one, we're going to go with a nice like burnt orange almost. And we'll just kind of paint a little bit of just some area in general. We'll make a new layer on top of that. Choose a different color. For this one, I might do a light color. I would say that choose like three or four colors that kind of one being quite light, one being quite dark, and one or two just somewhere in the middle of those. We're going to go with a nice navy blue as well on a new layer. And we're just filling in some of the edges here. This doesn't really matter too much since we're going to be messing with this quite a lot very soon. But we'll add one more color. We'll just add a nice golden yellow. There we go. So now we have all of our colors in a nice little blob here. We'll just group them all together and we're gonna merge them now. And what we can do, we'll go into blur, Gaussian blur. And we're gonna add about, just soften the edges kind of, just make them kind of wrap into each other a little bit. Nothing too severe, about 50% there. We'll go back into filter, we're gonna go to noise, press add noise, and we'll just add about 10% noise. And we'll do that on Gaussian noise monochromatic as well. Once again, these things don't really matter too much. It's just what I like to do. And now this is where it gets a little bit fun, right? So we're going to duplicate this layer. Make sure you're always duplicating the layer as well, just because you'll find that you want to go back to the older versions without having to command Z all the way back. So duplicate a new layer on top. And what we're going to do, this is the gold, yeah? This is where it really comes together. We go into edit, transform, and then warp. We get this little bounding box that kind of shows up. And what you can do is you can just drag it around and have a lot of fun with it, right? So this is how you get some really cool edges on the interior of any kind of graphic design, gradient orb, right? And now what I'm looking for when I do this is these kind of sharp edges that we've got going on around here, right? I really like the look of this. So when you get something that you're kind of just a little bit happy with, you can adjust the edges as well. Looking at kind of like a Pringle looking shape almost. Just enter out of that and you're going to notice it'll change a little bit, which I always find is quite nice. And there we go. We're already getting some of these finer, sharp edges going. Yeah. And it looks really good when you double it over the top of that existing background. So now that we have this one here, we're going to start masking it on top of some sort of shape, right? So I'm just going to create a nice big circle. We'll just grab one there. Center it, do whatever you want. Fill it in with a color. Doesn't really matter too much once again. And then I'm just going to do a little clipping mask I just press Alt and click in between the layers to do that. If you do the regular mask, then you can do that as well. And now we're getting in the idea of that circular orb, and it's starting to look pretty cool. Now this, you could finish it here, but what I like to do is I wanna go a little bit deeper, right? So we're gonna duplicate these layers one more time, and we're gonna merge them again. Make those ones invisible. And this is the existing merge layer, right? So what we do, as always, a bit more Gaussian blur. This time we're just gonna soften those kind of harder edges a little bit more. Go back into filter, add some noise again. Once again, about 10%. And what this does is it just kind of softens those harder edges and it makes it look a little bit cleaner and softer, which I think is a nice little technique. We're gonna go back into edit now, transform, warp. And then we're gonna warp the warped one, right? We're going to warp the already warped gradient orb. And this is creating some new sharper edges. And this can take a while to get right as well. You don't wanna really settle on the first one. A lot of the time I'll just press enter and then just command Z out of it if I'm not too happy with it and give it another crack. So I'll just have a play around with it and see if I can find anything that I'm happy with. We'll see how we go. Great, so this is what we've got going on here now. I duplicated the original one a few more times to kind of just bring back some of those sharper edges. And I really like matching them up with the curve of the shape itself. So it gets this really kind of satisfying inline almost here with that gradient warp kind of curving in with the circle. It makes it look a bit more marbly and a bit more three-dimensional as well, which I think is pretty cool. What I'm gonna do now is just kind of enhance some of the darker areas of this gradient orb. And what I like to do is I'll duplicate that original image, so as we've got here. And then actually, if you go into Image, Adjustments, and then you go into Threshold, what you can do is if you just play around with the threshold here, you can get some kind of darker edges, right? So I like it about there. I think that's enough kind of a portion of the original design, I guess, with that black area. And then what we can do now is go into our blending modes and just have a play around with what we think looks best. I usually find that it's this first little few, like darker color, darken or multiply. I really like darker color usually, so we're gonna take that one there. And this just, yeah, gets us some cooler kind of darker edges and gives it a bit more crunch, you know, a bit more bite, which is cool. And now that we have this one, we can really start to play around with it, right? So you can kind of move this black layer around a little bit of a cheeky displacement, or we could even go into edit and we can start warping that image again, and you can get some real kind of sharp accents that we can apply over that original image. But yeah, this is really up to you. You can also do the thresholding earlier in the process too, and you get some cool effects there as well. But I think if we just make it a little bit bigger there, a little bit bigger, change the corners a little bit by just pressing Control on the edges, around something like, we'll rotate it one more time. Something like this I'm finding is pretty cool. Just getting that darker side with the edges. And yeah, like I'm really happy with how this is going so far. So we'll just change it one more time to multiply. And there you go, you get some of those harsher kind of edges, which I think are quite nice. And now that we've got this black layer with just these kind of accented parts, we can change the color of that pretty easily. And there's a cool way of doing it. If you go into Select and then you do Color Range, and then you kind of touch that area affected. So this, I'm just clicking on this black area here. We're gonna get a nice selection of all that kind of space. We'll make a new layer on top. We'll clip that in as well. Go into our fill bucket and we're just gonna choose maybe like a nice kind of dark burnt orange almost. And we'll fill that in and we'll kind of see what we get. And as you can see, we're keeping that kind of noisy elements that we had from that thresholding effect that we put on. And yeah, you can kind of play around with it. Once we have this new layer as well, we can change the hue and saturation to get something that you like working with. Like even this nice red looks really nice. a pinky, hot pink almost. But we might just stick with something like that original orange, like there we go. And if we hide that underneath layer, it's just a good way of creating some kind of highlights, I guess, over the top of it. And rather than having these as gradients that most of the design has, it gives us just a pure noisy color rather than the softer gradients that we've applied throughout it. So that's a pretty cool advanced technique, I guess, if you want to do that on top of it. Some final touches that I like to do are just going into the filter once again. Once we've kind of merged everything, blurring it out and adding some more noise, just making it look as soft as possible. I think that gives it just a really cool subtle effect. Like, as you can see, it just kind of smooths it out, makes it feel a bit like, once again, going for that 3D look. And then, yeah, we've kind of got a finished product here, and you can do really whatever you want with this. Another thing that I like is going into image adjustments and then hue and saturation, just to kind of clean up some of the colors in the end. Like, we're getting some real nice shades of red when we go down this direction here. Maybe even darken it up a little bit. And then even going into the exposure settings and just brightening it. And then playing around with just a whole bunch of different photo manipulation stuff that Photoshop has to offer. And really, you can get some cool stuff here. So this is just all up to you at the end. You can just make it your own, make it whatever you would like. And I'm pretty happy with something like that. So yeah, there's your kind of gradient orb. Another thing that I would recommend is saving like a file with the original texture, right? So the pre-circle texture, I guess, and you can kind of build up a collection of a heap of these shapes, these gradient kind of maps almost. So whenever you open like a new file and you want to make a new gradient orb, you can just kind of chuck it in, clip it over a circle once again, and then if you want to make it completely brand new, all it takes is just a solid warp. And we've got a whole new design, right? Without having to go through that entire process once again. I do this a heap in my work. It saves me so much time. And honestly, it's like a 50-50 kind of thing for me. Like, if I start making one of these gradient things straight away, just from a fresh blank slate, half the time I'll like it, half the time I won't. So having those existing ones just helps clean things up a little bit. Makes your process a bit quicker if you're looking to post quite a bit, or if you just want to make things easy for yourself. So yeah, here's kind of our finished product. And it's this little gradient orb here. You can do a heap of other stuff with these shapes as well. Use them in designs however you would like. You can turn those original textures into 3D shapes if you want through Photoshop. That's a pretty cool thing that I might do in another video. You can also like slap some paper textures on top of it, text on top of it, do whatever. You can get some really cool stuff. So yeah, that's a basic tutorial of how I make these gradient orbs in Photoshop. I've seen there are plenty of other ways to do this, but this is what I find is easiest. And yeah, hopefully that helps. Hopefully it was pretty straightforward. But yeah, I'm going to show you some designs that I've done right now with gradient orbs that I've used. And yeah, you can get some really cool effects going on in a heap of different styles, heap of different colors. You can really just play around and have fun with it, because it's all about having fun at the end of the day. It's a fun little process and I love doing it. And hopefully you'll get some joy out of it as well. So that's it for my first video, my first ever YouTube video. Oh, what a joy. What a rush this was to film. I definitely didn't sit here for like 3 hours without pressing record because I didn't know how to introduce the video and then got nervous and stopped halfway through and got distracted again. And anyway, it's all the fun of video making, right? So if you like what I do, consider checking out my Instagram, Twitch, all that, if you want to see me design this stuff live on stream. And I also have a Patreon where I give early access to these videos. And I have 140 people that I want to thank right here in front of my screen. So yeah, big bless to everyone who's subbed to the Patreon in the past and for continuing my design journey to YouTube. And I'm going to have some fun over here and hopefully you'll have fun too. So make sure you hit that subscribe button, leave a like if this helped. And yeah, I guess I'll see you in the next video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments and hopefully I'll answer them. All right, see you later. Okay, bye. See ya.